Okay, Sheila, what are you making in the kitchen today?
I'm making old-fashioned strawberry jam. We did not use any pure fruit, and we don't use pectin. We use sugar and boiling. What you have to remember more than anything else is that you have to sterilize all your bottles before you use them. So you boil them for 10 minutes. And not only your bottles, you have to boil your ladle you're going to be using, the tongs with which you remove the bottles, the funnel which you use to pour the jam into the bottles, and a sieve in boiling water with the lids on. These lids have a rubber casing underneath, and they need to be soft to give you a good contact with your bottles.
So all that has to be boiled.
That's 10 minutes to sterilize everything. Never wash your berries with the tops off. So in preparing your berries, rinse them, drain them with the tops off, then take the tops off, slice them in half or a quarter, depending, and then you mush them with your potato masher.
Okay, can you move that over so we can see that? I'll zoom in.
And all it is mushed berries. And then you measure carefully because it depends on how much sugar is how much berries you have. I have approximately 4 cups of berries. You pour that into your pot.
All right, I'm going to move over here.
Start boiling them on a high medium.
That's just the berries now.
Just the berries. Now we have 4 cups of berries. For every cup of berry, you need a cup of sugar.
So but one you, to one.
You yes. So I have to go over and get my measuring cup over here, Brian.
Okay.
Only put half in to start with.
Half what?
Half of the 4 cups of sugar because you've got 4 cups of berries.
But you only put 2 cups in if you have 4 cups of berries initially.
Yes.
Okay. You put how much sugar in there so far?
You put half the amount of sugar. Put in 2 cups now. And you're putting it on medium-high, and you're going to bring it to a rolling boil.
What's a rolling boil?
A rolling boil cannot be stirred down. A little boil, you can stir it down.
And what does that stir it down mean? If you stir it, it would stop boiling?
Yes. If you stir to a rolling boil, that's fine. Okay. And then you add, do that for 5 minutes.
Right, so you have to bring this to a rolling boil for 5 minutes.
For 5 minutes.
So you just set a timer, right? Correct? Is that what you just did?
Yeah. Actually, well, it hasn't come to a boil yet.
Oh, so you
what I'm timing now is the disinfecting of the jam jars. Oh, they have to boil in water for 10 minutes.
For 10 minutes, okay.
That's everything. Your ladle, your funnel, and your tongs.
Now, why again do you have to boil that? Is it just for sanitary?
10 minutes, yes. 10 minutes will kill any germs around. You don't want your jam to spoil.
You can't put it in a microwave to kill germs?
That's a moot point.
What does that mean?
Because some people think you can. You can certainly bring water to a boil. But if you bring water to a boil for 10 minutes in a microwave, you're not going to have any liquid left.
Yeah, okay.
It'll boil right out. This is the old-fashioned method.
This is good. It's a good wet method. Tastes good. Those berries look nice.
Now I have to go and get my butter and my lemon.
Your butter and your what?
Lemon.
Oh, lemon.
Lemon is setsa.
Lemon sets the...
sets the gem.
Sets the gem. Now, you mentioned pectin, that you don't use pectin. Explain to our viewers what pectin is.
Pectin occurs in fruit, and it's a natural substance which, when combined with sugar, causes the fruit to form almost a gel. You can use sertol as a commercial product. You don't have to use as much sugar, and you don't have to cook it as long, but it doesn't taste as good. So when you buy jam in the store, if it says pure strawberry jam, that's all it is. Strawberries and sugar.
Okay, Sheila, so what do you got, butter there?
You need a piece of butter like that. As my grandmother used to say, the size of a pullet egg, which is the smallest egg you can have. That helps to prevent the foaming, because you have to scrape all that foaming off. And if you put a little butter in, it helps to prevent a lot of foaming.
And the foaming comes from the boiling?
You can see now all this pinky white stuff coming to the surface.
Okay.
And we don't want that in the jam. Right. So you have to keep putting, taking it off.
So you put that pullet size piece of butter in there, and that helps remove
it? Not until the 5 minutes of boiling.
After the 5 minutes of boiling, okay.
And then you got to boil it for 10 minutes.
With the rest of the sugar?
Yeah.
Because we only have half the sugar in there right now.
A little interesting things you pick up is that when you're foaming, removing the foam, use a metal spoon. Okay. And the metal spoon helps to remove it. But if you're using a special kind of pot, you got to be very careful you don't scrape it.
Oh, one of those, yeah. One of those.
Now, see, Brian, it's boiling.
But it's
I can
a
stir
rolling
it down.
Boil.
I can stir it down. It has to come to a rolling boil.
So, Sheila, when did you learn this recipe?
70 years ago.
And your mother used to make the jam.
Yep. And during World War II, we did everything. We preserved all our fruit, vegetables, jams. Even though sugar was rationed, they allowed us a little more to preserve our food. Now, that's almost rolling. Okay. That's rolling.
Okay.
5 minutes.
Now, you're going to set the timer. Okay.
The timer's on for that. Where's timer? You see what a rolling boil looks like?
Yeah, so we're looking at that, yes.
I have tasted pure strawberry jam, Schmucker's for instance, and in my opinion it's just as good, but it's a little thicker than I like my jams. And I don't imagine there'll be many more years where I'll be making this.
Well, there better be. Because I want to be eating it for many more years.
That's why you're learning to do it yourself.
That's right.
And, of course, this recipe came from the time that my grandparents and great-grandparents had their own strawberry fields. And they'd go out and pick the strawberries at first light, come home, make jam.
And so, is there any... particular type of strawberry that works better? What did you pick here and why?